Could not have created a greater day, a greater moment to see these two hearts be joined as one. And you've been invited here to be a part, not just to spectate, but to participate in this union of these two lives. And we're here to celebrate what God has put in the heart for Ben, for Amne, and what God has put in the heart for Amne, for Ben. And so you have been invited here to do that. And I know that there's someone else who's been invited as well, and that is our Heavenly Father. So let me pray. Father God, thank you so much for all you do and for all you have done and for all you will continue to do. And I thank you for the promise of marriage, the promise of family, and the promise of love. And today, Father, we ask that your presence is felt as we join these two hearts as one. And that we can see what great, great promise and future it is that you have in store for Ben and Amne. In Jesus' name, amen. Amne, Ben, would you do me a favor and just turn around and look at everyone that's here? They're here because they love you. They're here because they want to share this special moment with you. And it's just a moment that like this that we're able to see two young people join hearts as one as they begin their life together. And to me, I think that demonstrates the love that both you have for each other and that you can see that marriage is a very serious commitment, yet it is also a time for joy and a time for excitement and celebration. So Ben and Amne, I charge you both to remember that the marriage is something that is God-ordained in that he has created, and that the relationship in any marriage partnership must be that God be maintained at the center of your relationship. I charge you both to the commitment that you're making today. Ben, do you now solemnly swear to establish one home with Amne as her husband, to receive her as your wife, to make a home where she will be loved and cared for as God grants her life? And Amne, do you now solemnly swear to establish your own home with Ben and to be his wife and to receive him as your husband and to make a home where he will be loved and cared for as long as God grants him life? You too have been brought to this moment in your lives not by accident. I truly believe that you're here because of intentional loving relationships, people that are here to celebrate you, your marriage, your friends, your teachers, your life experiences, your family, and especially your parents, as they have played a pivotal role in this moment. Mr. and Mrs. Burney, Tom and Linda, you've raised Ben up to be the fine young man that he is today. And you've taught him by example and love and following the words of Scripture, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So do you now promise to encourage Ben and Amne in their marriage to be an example of love and devotion to them to follow, to help them build a strong and stable home for themselves and their family? Tim and Rhonda, you've raised Amne to be in a Christian home and have taught her the love of Christ by example and by instruction. So following the words of Scripture, God said it's not good for man to be alone, and so he created woman to be by his side. So do you promise now to encourage Ben and Amne to present an example of love and devotion for them to follow, and to help them build a strong and stable home for themselves and their future family? Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Amen. By placing Amne's hand into Ben, you are signifying the uniting of their hearts and the pledging of their love as one, blessing the union of their lives together. She placed her hand into his. Ashton, you have some words of Scripture to be read.
This is 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4. Love is patient, love is kind. It isn't jealous, it doesn't brag. It isn't arrogant, it isn't rude. It doesn't seek its own advantage, it isn't irritable. It doesn't keep a record of complaints. It isn't happy with injustice, but it is happy with the truth. Love puts up with all things, trusts in all things, hopes for all things, endures all things. Love never fails.
Some powerful words as God describes what love is. Some people look at the Bible as something that's out of date or something that's irrelevant to our society. But if you read it, at the very core, God has ordained and created this incredible relationship between a man and a woman. In fact, at the very beginning of his word, he says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother, be united with his wife, and the two will become one flesh." And it says, "They were both naked, and they were not ashamed." And to me, I think God gives four very practical, powerful promises to couples who give their lives to the vows of these scriptures. I think he says, first of all, that there's a promise of priority in your life. For this reason, a man will leave, he says, and we've come to a point right now that you will choose your own priorities. And it's our prayer that you choose your number one priority to be God. Having him first makes all the difference in everything that you do, because he's the heart and he has created the love that you have for each other. He instilled in you the desire to become one. And it makes sense then to put him first in everything that you do, and everything that you hope for, and everything that you dream for as a married couple. Because with him, you'll have everything. And without him, it's going to be a struggle. But please understand this. Don't say, "God is first, and then my spouse is second, and then my family, and then my..." No. That's not what God means by putting him as a priority. Having God number one says, God will be number one in everything. God will be number one with my spouse. God will be number one with my family. He'll be number one with my career. God is weaved in every fabric of your life, so that the promise of priority means he remains one. There is also the promise of pursuit. You see, once you leave your parents, you become united with each other. And that term, united, means a constant uniting, a constant pursuing of each other. You know, it's pretty sad that so many couples stop pursuing each other after the wedding. And in reality, this is when the pursuing can be really fun. Pursue each other then with your words. Pursue each other with your actions and with your heart. And today I want you to promise to pursue each other beyond this moment for eternity. That third promise is the promise of partnership. God said the two shall become one. So many people think that's a physical union. Not so. It also means that you'll have a total union in your thought, a total union in your dreams and your hopes and your wishes, a total union in your chores, like dishes, taking out the trash, cleaning up the house. But the concept is a mutual commitment and submission to each other, because your thoughts now are for each other and not for yourself. And then the last one is the promise of purity. God said the two were naked and they were not ashamed. In other words, they had nothing to hide from each other. There was no secrets. There was nothing hidden. You were totally vulnerable, totally open. And they enjoyed one another. They kept open communication, open arms, and open hearts to each other. That's the promise a purity. You see, there's no shame when your love is pure, and there's no shame when your love is honest. And I know that many couples, they think happiness is a goal to pursue in their marriage, but happiness is a result of a relationship that fulfills these promises. It's a result of a byproduct of an incredible hard work. You guys take these promises true, and you'll have a true marriage. I don't know any marriage that accidentally becomes pure, or accidentally becomes more romantic, or accidentally becomes more intimate. Great marriages work because great work goes into the marriage. So you take these four promises, and they lead, I believe, right into the vows that you're about ready to speak to one another. And I think it's incredible that you wrote your own vows to speak to each other. So Ben, would you do the honor of speaking your vows, not only to Amne, but in front of God and family and friends?
Dear Amne, over the past 4 years, I have grown to love many things about you. Your compassion, your selflessness, your loyalty, your undeniable faith, your beautiful smile, your awesome cooking, your excitement for life, and your extremely big heart. God made you a truly unique and special person. Choosing a spouse is one of the biggest decisions people make, but it was one of the easiest decisions I've had to make. As we continue our lives together, I promise to always support you in all of your dreams, always speak well of you, and always be here for you. I promise to listen to you, love you, forgive you, and be faithful to you. I promise to help you grow in your faith and always keep God as the center of our family. You really are my best friend, and I'm very excited for you to also be my wife.
Ben, 4 years ago I met you in Earhart's computer lab. I was reluctant to enter that room, but little did I know that I was going to meet the guy who would be my best friend for life. I love that you are a godly man. I love that you are driven in reaching for your dreams that I couldn't even imagine reaching for. I love that you are thoughtful and compassionate, and I love that you make me a better person. I love that you are always calm and so easily pleased. I am so blessed that you have chosen me to spend the rest of your life with. I can't promise to be a perfect wife, but I do promise to be an open communicator as well as your personal cheerleader and number one fan. I promise to be a sounding board as you make decisions as the head of our family. I promise to be your constant companion. And I don't know what God has planned for us, but I promise to love you and hold your hand every step of the way. I am so excited and cannot wait to start our lives together. I promise to be the best wife that I can for the rest of my life.
Awesome vows, both of you, from the heart, awesome vows. Amne and Ben have chosen to not only say those vows, but to seal those vows with the giving and receiving of rings. And so may I have the rings? Perfect. These rings are special, not because of the precious metal, but because of what they represent. And they represent the commitment that you're making to each other today. And when you give each other these rings, you'll be saying other promises as well that you can repeat after me. But there are also promises not to remind each other of this day, but to remind everyone else who looks upon your hand that you are spoken for, that you have given your heart to each other. So, Ben, if you'll take Amne's ring, and if you'll place it upon her finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving husband with all my heart's affection. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And Amne, if you'll take Ben's, and please repeat after me. With this ring, I seal my promise to be your faithful and loving wife with all my heart's affection. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Over here to my left is a representation of what will happen to your illustration to your heart and to your marriage. I'm going to pour in the white sand at the bottom there, and that will represent the foundation of your marriage being God. And then if you two would pour in the different colored sands representing your lives together, and then I will also continuously pour in the white sand to represent that God is also intertwining your marriage as one. And then, just as it would be very difficult to pick out each particle of color, may it be just as difficult for anyone to pick apart your love for each other. Forever to represent this day, forever to represent the continuous blessing of your hearts mending and blending together. Then, Amne, you've come before your family and friends, before our Heavenly Father in heaven, and you've expressed your desire to be husband and wife. And you've shown your love and affection by the joining of hands and having made promises of faith and devotion, and you've sealed those promises by the giving and receiving of rings. And so, makes me very happy to pronounce that you are indeed husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ben, you may kiss your wife. Makes me very happy to be the first one to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Ben and Amne Burney.